Janet. Good morning, Hilda. Good morning, Monica. Morning, Louise. Hilda. Avril, good morning. You're all very welcome to the Harry Edward Virtual Healing Minute. We'll wait a little longer while you relax with the music playing this morning. The music is beautiful piano music by Pedro Helen called Sunny Morning, Beautiful Relaxing Healing Music. Morning, Alan. Morning, Shirley. Morning, Linda. Morning, Louise. Morning, Tosca. Good morning, Janelle. Morning, Bev. Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us today on the Harry Edwards Sanctuary's Healing Minute. We're truly grateful that this great community of like-minded people come together, link up and send wonderful healing energies to all in need, and a special welcome to newbies that have joined us today. My name is Penny, coming from my home in Surrey on 16th of February 2024. My reading today will come from the Chicken Soup of Soul Count Your Blessings series called Blessing Bowl. Hope is important because it can make the present moment less difficult to bear. We believe that tomorrow will be a better. We can bear a hardship today. From the dailyinspirationlife.com. This morning, small, quick 5-minute meditation is a chance to invoke more hope into your day. Hope is a feeling of expectation, of desire for certain things to happen. Close your eyes. Allow yourself to relax. Settle into the comfort and let your breathing slow down. Relax and be there in your body, calm and soft. Hope lives within us as a dream, reminds us that there is more. Hope gives us strength when we're weak. It feeds us when we starve. Bring your hand to your heart now and ask hope to rise. Feel the warmth, the kindness, and the grace. Feel the dreaming, the imagination, the creativity. Feel the excitement, the adventure, the potential. Hope your day is light. I hope your day is full of love and hope. As we all come together at the Harry Edwards Healing Sanctuary for the attunement and grounding, close your eyes and just be still. Imagine a column of pure white light entering your entire being. And be present in this love, this light, for it has a message for you personally. Imagine that light condescending all light limited boundaries that we are currently aware of. Imagine that the light connects every individual hearing. This and a portrait of light now behind to formulate within you and around you as each one connects to the healing purpose. The center of your being is a connection to the earth energy. From this point within, light is anchored to you. Sit and rest and begin to sense the earth energy, the healing energy of the divinity. You are each a conduit of both energies. Allow them to flow through you. You can fill your entire with these energies just by being. From that space, either by thought, intention or touch, you are able to illuminate the light within another. Distance is no barrier to these energies. A great invocation. From the point of light that I am, I let stream forth from the mind of God. Earth radiates with it light. From the point of light within the heart of God, I let light stream forth from my heart. I am a channel, radiant energy on earth. From the center where the will of God is known, I let the divine purpose guide me, the purpose with all masters know and serve. From the center of the divine human race, I let plan, love and light work out. My love seals the door where evil dwells. I am the light, the love and power living God's plan on earth. Harry Edwards prayer. May I be thankful for the blessings I already have. Grant me relief, pain and sickness. Protect me from all ills and grant me good health in the days to come. Remove all causes of imperfection and bring your healing ministers close to me that I might be conscious of your presence and receive guidance and inspiration. Grant me courage and fortitude to overcome all adversity. Let me be conscious of your strength in all times of need. Give me confidence to overcome my fears and not to anticipate harm. Teach me how to live rightly in your sight, to do only that which is right and true. I pray good guidance and right influencing will inspire all your peoples to be as brothers, one to the other, and that peace shall endure all time. A prayer for hope. Heavenly Father, I am your humble servant. I come before you today in need of hope. There are times when I feel helplessness. There are times when I feel weak. I pray for hope. I need hope for a better future. I need hope for a better life. I need hope for love and kindness. Some say the sky is at its darkest when the light, just before the light. I pray that this is true and all seems dark. I lead you light, Lord, in every way. I pray to be filled with your light from head to toe and bask in your glory. I pray that all is right in the world as you have planned us, as you want it to be. Help me to walk in light and live my life in faith and glory. And in your name I pray, Amen. Now all the people whose names we hold in the distant healing folder and across the world, we received healing for the highest good. We also request healing for the families and friends, animals, people who have requested distant healing. We now call in Harry Edwards and his healing teams and our healing teams in your intentions to let all be placed in the healing light and receive that which we allow to receive for the highest good. We'll now have a minute's silence to send out the healing out in the world today. Thank you, and blessings for all the help here today and all our friends in spirit. Thank you, everyone. That was so peaceful and powerful. Schedule for the next week. Let's see. Okay. Saturday the 17th at the sanctuary, there's forest bathing from 10 to 12:30. There's also a workshop, right into the chakra workshop, from 10:30 to 3:45. Next Sunday, the 25th, is the service run by Jean from 11 to 12 o'clock, and it'll be live on Facebook as well. On the Thursday the 29th, the spiritual development group from 11 to 2:30 p.m. And on the same day, on the 29th, John's doing a meditation and be back on Zoom and Facebook. And not forgetting the terrace lounge where you can get cakes or anything to eat between 9:30 and 3:30. My reading today from Chicken Super Soul series, The Blessing Bowl. My daughter's first birthday, I was so thrilled that we were celebrating a year of her life, but saddened at how hard this year had been. We had spent 61 days in hospital, battling seizures, infections, two flights on the life helicopter ride, numerous 911 calls, and night trips in the ambulance. My daughter Samantha was a sick little girl, and we're still searching for a diagnosis. To honour Samantha's first year, I'd asked people to bring a trinket, a stone, a poem, something that brought peace or felt good to them, their blessings for her. I found a simple bowl given to me by my great mother and grandmother, a bowl for her blessing bowl. I find my tribulation to the bowl in the garden. Many times I've set my fragile daughter on the soft soil, hoping something might soak up from Mother Earth. My affirmation at the time, grow, thrive, baby girl, take example from courgettes growing. I snipped a bloom from a lily I planted the summer my husband and I married. The bloom was buttery yellow with three soft petals. Samantha, my husband and myself. I held a bit of soil from the earth in my hand from the former hard clump and added it to the bowl. My offering was simple but represented the growth, hope my little family could be more precious. Samantha woke up on this precious day at 4 p.m. when the party was going to start. She's on so many anti-seizure meds that waking up fully can take an hour, yet today she was lucid and playing in a crib, ready to go for a party. I put her in a blue dress and yellow daisies. I've been saving that dress. I was waiting for her to be big enough, waiting for the first year so she could wear it. The blue brought out the red hair. I placed tiny turquoise shell of glasses on her nose and laughed to myself. She was absolutely the most precious thing on earth. Grandparents, aunts, uncles, cousins filed in, kissed Samantha, wine bottles were uncorked, hummus and brie were laid on the table. The mood was festive and everyone toasted Samantha's health. As the evening progressed, the dinner plates cleared away. It was time for our blessing bowl ceremony. Samantha was still awake, babbling to her grandmother and seizure free. I felt enormous weight lift off my shoulder. I brought my great grandmother's bowl and set it in front of her family. Studying their faces in front of me, I thought what a long haul that it's been for everyone. The sleepless nights, the worried phone calls, private tears carried away from the hospital, all for our daughter. I felt overwhelmed and gratitude. I cleared my throat and thanked my family for being there. I reached into the bowl and pulled out my blessings for Samantha, the soil and our flower. I passed the bowl on to the grandmother. She pulled out a silver bell in the shape of an angel, because Samantha is our angel. When my talkative grandmother gets emotional, she's a lady with little words. She passed the bowl on to another, Samantha's grandma. She pulled out a sand dollar she found on a Californian beach. I chose the sand dollar because it came from the ocean. The ocean is beautiful, constant, volatile, source of life. The surface can be stormy, but never really see what's going on below. And there is a whole different world below. This reminds me of Samantha. We don't really know what's going on underneath the surface, but there is a beautiful world full of life. My aunt pulled out a silver heart. I carried this heart with me for 20 years and brought me good luck. So all these years, Samantha, I hold it to you. She passed the bowl on to my sister-in-law and presented a prayer, a health and longevity from the Buddhist temple in Hong Kong. My mother had chosen shells, a perfectly brown white spiral that I found years ago during a family vacation in Florida. The second come from Tahiti. Another smooth shell chosen thousands of miles away years before Samantha was born. The last trinket was a jade necklace from Hong Kong. My sister-in-law is from China. I went to visit her mother in May. Her mother gave her the necklace to give Samantha good luck. 34 years ago, her son wore the necklace for good health and safety during babyhood. The span of people loving and praying for Samantha that had travelled thousands of miles. I lit a single candle, overwhelmed that this beautiful little girl was part of my life, that she thought so hard to stay a part of our lives. Samantha's dad helped to blow out the candle. The night came to the end. I finally got my rowdy daughter to sleep. I wandered through the house, remembering the night. I took the lily out of the bowl and placed it in the big family Bible to press for safety and keeping. The Bible belonged to my grandfather, who passed away a decade ago. As I fumbled through the pages, I found a rose, red rose, perfectly pressed between the passages. I didn't know the origins, but I put it in the bowl. It's my grandfather's wish for Samantha. We ask so much of our families, our friends and people we don't know. We spend countless hours in hospital, bought meals, coffees, contacted our family members, helped and loved Samantha, praised Jade and Payne for Hong Kong. How do you give back? Gratitude and thought and hope, my gratefulness for my daughter's pink cheeks, for every breath she takes, for a Caesar-free birthday. I'm grateful for my families and friends who give their silver heart for blessing bowl. Someday I will repay the world for their acts of kindness and our family. I will make meals for someone else. I will send their family wishes of good health and visit the hospital with coffee and fresh brownies. Right now I can only reflect on the joy the night has been grateful by Simon, Heather Simons. A poem, Hope Sustains Life. Hope is force. Hope is energy. Hope is strength. Hope is life. Hope is equality. Hope is empowerment. Hope is justice. Hope is life. Hope is sincerity. Hope is tolerance. Hope is harmony. Hope is life. Hope for a peaceful world. Hope for a promising world. Hope for a beginning world. Hope for a lively, living, and lovable world. My music chosen today is Lee Ann Warwick. I Hope You Dance. Do remember, if you want healing or just a chat, we're here for you. Whether you come to the sanctuary or for contact healing or wish to have telephone or Zoom healing, just contact us in a normal way. Arrange your appointment. Details on website, on Facebook. Stuart will be with you tomorrow, on Saturday, 17th. I'll be with you on Sunday, 18th. And Tracy will be with you on Monday. Hope quote, never stop believing in hope because miracles happen every day. As you remember, our motto states, wherever you are, we're here for you. Big thank you for joining us today on Live on Catch Up. May your lights always shine through the days ahead. Have a wonderful weekend. I'll see you on Sunday if you're coming in. And bye for now. Please take care. And thank you very much for joining us today. Bless you all. Thank you.